अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद में जीते हैं बाबा, तेरी याद में जीते हैं बाबा, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, रहे याद सदा ही साथ तेरी, रहे याद सदा ही साथ तेरी, बस और न हम कुछ चाहेंगे, बस और न हम कुछ चाहेंगे, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं। पल बीते तेरी यादों में, जो पल बीते तेरी यादों में, वो पल अविनाशी होते हैं, वो पल अविनाशी होते हैं, हर पल को सफल बना देंगे, हर पल को सफल बना देंगे, तेरी याद कभी ना छोड़ेंगे, तेरी याद कभी ना छोड़ेंगे, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं। प्रभु संग संग बाबा, यूं ही आप प्रभु संग संग बाबा, इस दुनिया के सुख पाने क्या, इस दुनिया के सुख पाने क्या, लहराते रहे तेरी यादों में, लहराते रहे तेरी यादों में, उन यादों में खो जाएंगे, उन यादों में खो जाएंगे, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद में जीते हैं बाबा, तेरी याद में जीते हैं बाबा, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, रहे याद सदा ही साथ तेरी, रहे याद सदा ही साथ तेरी, बस और न हम कुछ चाहेंगे, बस और न हम कुछ चाहेंगे, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं, तेरी याद का अमृत पीते हैं।
ओम शांति। टुडेज सदगुरु बाबा डे, सो टेकिंग एवरीवन्स रिमेम्बरेंस, व्हेन बाबा कॉल मी टू ऑफर बोर्ड, इट वाज वेरी वेरी लवली, वेरी पावरफुल दृष्टि फ्रॉम बाबा। Baba was looking at all of us, sharing drishti with us. Then I said, Baba, I brought bhog today. And then Baba accepted bhog with love. Then I said, Baba, it feels like we should stay with you now, or you should stay with us. So Baba was smiling and Baba said, you all children have been given some special places. I said, Baba, we don't want to be in this world now. So Baba was saying, is it every one of you? I said, no, we have more attraction to be in the subtle regions in a subtle form. So then Baba said that, yeah, you can stay with me. And then Baba was saying that Baba had been giving you all this drill of five forms, and especially in eternal form, you can come and be in Paramdham or in subtle regions. And also with your original form, deity form, you can be in golden age. So Baba says that you children are special souls. I said, Baba, these days, you know, all over they must be calling you, and you have to take care of so many children. So Baba said, yes, everyone receives according to their effort. But because you children have recognized Baba, and also because you children are living the life of purity, but also following directions of Baba, you all are instruments. Everyone is instrument. So because of that, Baba has a special love, a special service for all of you. It was so interesting, very lovingly. And then Baba said, but you all have to reach to your karmati stage, your stage of perfection. So I said, Baba, we all are, we all have aim and we are making efforts. Baba said that there is lot of different kinds of services happening as you becoming perfect. Even you are not aware, but actually it's creating lot of different service. Baba showed that how when we all sit in meditation or we create the vibrations of peace, then there are many, many souls who receive peace. They feel the current of God's love. They feel that light is coming. So Baba says that as much you keep increasing your power to remain in one state and spread the vibrations, Baba said, very incognito service will keep happening. And of course, Baba said, you all always have plans. You all are serving, sustaining. But from your stage, lot of incognito service is happening. So I was kind of looking at Baba. He knows and he's saying it. But we have to just keep doing service from our avyakt stage, our stage of perfection. And then Baba said, lots of love to each one of you. Om Shanti. Special love to Sister Madhvi, come from Queens and Gayatri Band. We are seeing each other after so many months, right? But doesn't feel because we all see each other in Zoom. So Baba's love, especially for both of you. There is a saying that student life is the best life. How many of you wanted to study more, but you couldn't? Can I see hands? Many of you. Or there are some of you who didn't want it to study much, right? It's both ways. So Baba, when he adopts us, then we are his children. Then he wants us to make us worthy children. Baba talks about all virtues, all manners, all qualifications. And then for 21 verse, all the talents, everything has to be in us. So then Baba becomes teacher and he teaches us. So Baba is our teacher. Many, many times in the Murli, Baba says that God is teaching you. So there should be so much intoxication. And as I was mentioning yesterday, that the way Baba teaches us and always looks at us as in his, very, very uplifting drishti, never makes us feel that we are ordinary or we have done something wrong. No, Baba's drishti is always, always uplifting. And always we feel that we belong to Baba. So Baba, when he becomes teacher, every morning he teaches us. Even now, when you read Murli, we read Murli, we do feel immediately, this is what Baba is saying. We don't say Baba said this 40 years ago or Baba said this 50 years ago, no. And every word, what is needed in our lives at confluence age, that comes in the Murli. Appropriate, accurate blessing comes in the Murli. So this morning when Baba was saying, because our study is from Murli, our source is Murli, our love for Baba is listening to Baba's Murli. That's our love. Because it's through the Murli that, through this study, that we become elevated. And not only that, but when we study, then Baba also teaches us many, many practices, experiments, and then we are also becoming. So this morning, Baba said that as much you follow directions of Baba, or as soon as you start following directions of Baba, your lock of intellect opens. So do you think our lock is completely open or no? So when lock will open, what you will find? It's very interesting because Baba gives the knowledge of three aspects of time. Past, present, future. Beginning of cycle, middle and end, and then the beginning. And everyone, I think all of us, to certain extent, some might be to more extent, feel that whenever you have to discern something through your intellect, there is always somewhere some kind of influence. Could be past experience, could be something from the past. So today we had a lot of discussion on that, how come it's the sanskar from the past. It creates some kind of thoughts and it affects our intellect. And then we decide based on that experience from the past. Whether about a person, about a situation, it could be anything. So this first form, eternal form, I practiced last whole year that whenever like I have to write email or I have to respond to someone and I know that there might be some emotions involved or some of the past experience might be, I immediately went in and have that external stage where there is love, there is peace. And then power to discern and to think. So each form, actually, more I think that as much awareness and the practice of these forms will increase and we start using it in practical life. Immediately you will see how much deep connection it has to help us to discern and decide what is elevated and beneficial. Elevated and beneficial. So connection, you know, since yesterday I've been thinking a lot on connection between using this form, effect on the power to discern. So there is influence. There is influence of even 1%, 10% may not be 100%. But to do actions, not only beneficial, but which doesn't create any bondage. Because generally action will create some bondage, right? But action done in the eternal stage will help the way we will discern and decide. It will create, we will create fortune, new beginning in a way. Because when you think in that stage, in that form, and as I said, then it's connection with power to discern. So first important thing is that when we listen to Murli, I think most of us have this habit of churning Murli. And churning in Hindi is called Vichar Sagar Manthan. That there is an ocean of knowledge and you churn. So then you are able to get some more sense, more essence of the Murli. But then there is something called reflections, which is something more deeper that I understand, but deeply within. In Hindi, it is called Manan Chintan. Manan Chintan is considered to be something higher than just the churning of knowledge. So after reflection, internally, like you're feeling that lock is opening more, and the third natural experience come is deep insights, you know. I think we all experience, but I find that suddenly you feel that silence also could be of eyes because you don't want to see much. Could be of ears because you don't want to listen. You want to stay in that seed form stage or in silence. Silence can be of any organ, not only of words. I don't know if you feel like, you know, you don't want to really listen more. There are some these days, keep listening, more listening. And some days I find I really don't want to listen anything. I don't want to even see anything. So how, you know, the insights come because as we are moving forward on journey, so this is not only we are intellectually churning, but you are really internally experiencing that what is true silence. And soul in one of these forms, eternal or Adi, is just in such a sweet experience of silence and bliss that doesn't want to do anything in the sense of add more into more listening or more. So silence, as I said, insights start coming. And from insights to other things happen. Something is called farsightedness. No, Baba say, Dura Deshi Buddhi. Some children are farsighted. Some only see what is at present, but some are able to see far. So their power to discern, where they are not only farsighted, but with Dadi Prakashmani, she was also foresighted. Why we will ask Dadi, share your thought. What was your thought So it was not her desire. It was not promotion of organization. But it was a thought, according to drama, what are the next scenes? She will feel it. And that is why every thought got accomplished, every thought. Anything she said, let's do this. As soon as she said it, there were so many, they were ready to make it happen. The creation you see there, you see Peace Park, you see Panda Bhavan, Gyan Sarovar, then Shantivan. Any thought she had, let's celebrate this as tapasya, year of tapasya, that this thought will get accomplished. Because it's like coming from last kalpa, she was so aligned with the time, that right thought at the right time, and it will happen. Accomplishment of thought, we call it siddhi. Siddhi sarup, that means every thought get accomplished. And it's not connected, as I said, with her desires or anything. So farsighted, in the sense of, it's like you see very clearly whether it's the attainments, rewards, or any consequences. But your intellect, power to discern and decide, works in such a way. This is called third eye. And then they show Shankar has third eye. When he opened, there was destruction. And that's true. Because even our third eye, when it opens, actually all the obstacles can be destroyed. Anything which is evil can be removed. Because we are also doing tapasya, right? So Shankar, as a tapasvi, opened eyes and destruction happened. So it's not really Shankar. All of us, in our bodiless state, as a tapasvi, anything which has to be negative, evil, obstacle, can be removed, can be destroyed from that stage, so that we become also free from obstacles. So as a Baba's child, as a Brahmin, power to discern for us is very important this time. As I was mentioning, that making right choices for everything, and especially at this time. Like yesterday, I woke up and I'm hearing this word, wind up, wind up. I said, what wind up? What to wind up? Is it internal, external? And I had been thinking about it, why Baba says wind up? Because when you have to wind up, then you have to sort out, and whatever is waste, whatever is not necessary, but whatever is essential and important stays with us. So time is such that we all, each one of us, even if we are today collective, together in a family, but many times it happens, you are alone. Like, I have to decide. Even I can take help from others, but finally I have to decide. So this clarity of intellect, so it's very deeply connected with practice of these five forms. And since I realized it, that every form I am creating, like if I'm creating Adi, original one, so the sanskars of bestower will emerge. So it's not only through intellect we are doing exercise, but it's creating in us the qualities of that state. Baba said deities are always bestows, they give. They give blessings, they give everyone, they are always donors, great donors. So when I am angel, I stay double light, so that everyone else can be light also. But because of any reason, if I become stressed, there is tension, heaviness, then whole energy around us also becomes same. If I am Brahmin, then I study and then also teach others. And I like when Baba keeps saying these days, be an example by self-transformation, which gives courage to others. Keep moving forward so others can get enthusiasm also. So go deeper into how three aspects of knowledge. They're called darshi. Darshi means one who can see three aspects of time. And that's where our lock of intellect opens, but also the intellect becomes also, and Baba said, gift of divine intellect, but it's like third eye. And you know that people, you know, they really think of the third eye as it could be wisdom, it could be higher intellect, awareness. So third eye. So now this is the time, use three aspects of time and let Baba open our intellect. So when the lock is completely open, 100%, then what will happen? As I said, you will find lot of treasures, virtues of Baba, love of Baba, blessings from Baba. You will find treasures, so many treasures, like all attainments in the life. Because when lock opens, then what comes out are all these beautiful treasures. That is why when Baba keeps saying in the Murli, children, you must claim full inheritance. So I keep saying, what is full inheritance? Full inheritance means all the qualities of Baba. He is ocean, I have to be master. Baba is ocean love, I have to be master ocean of love. Baba is ocean of peace, I have to be master ocean of peace. So I have to become master, master ocean. And that's what really, as much I follow directions of Baba. Remember these words. As much I follow Srimat of Baba. Srimat for my thoughts, for my time, for my relationships, for body, for wealth, all resources. So why he doesn't open intellect from very beginning? He said, no, as much you follow my directions, the intellect keeps opening. Because that's your attainment, you know, finally. So when you follow directions of Baba, follow Baba, then you have full inheritance. And when I think about some of the ancestor souls, one of the ancestor souls, we mentioned about Vishwakishore Bhau. Baba used to call him right hand. Because whatever Baba said, it's not a question of he did it. But he was such a kind of right hand. It's like always there, available. And all the sisters, dadis, when they talk about him, was a big, big support to Yagya. And of course, if Baba says, go get medicine, there is no money. So somewhere he will get 10 tablets and they will make 4 pieces and give to those who have fever because they couldn't buy more. But how, whatever he did, so he told me once I was leaving for Delhi, he came to bus stand and said, whenever you have difficulty, you should be happy. I said, Baba told me something else you are saying. He said, because you will remember Baba so much that not only he will help you, he will get it done. But also when you will remember, so many your sins will be destroyed. Your love will increase. So that means he never had any fear of obstacles. what could happen, this might happen, that might happen. How many thoughts we get for every little thing. So today's slogan, if we are detached and lovely, we can use full stop within a second and there won't be any waste thoughts. That's the speciality of Brahmin life, is we are very detached and we are also lovely. So reflect more on third eye and really internally see where I am at now. And then Baba said, within 1 second, five forms. I thought that's fast, no? It's like even five forms is really Swadarshan Chakradhari. So how quickly you can spin. If you have to really kill devil, you can't do it slowly. You have to do it fast, right? So eternally, love and peace, Adi Sarup, bestower, giver of blessings, your own place, memorial and temples, double light as angel, and a server constant as a Brahmin. So every time you do one quality of each form, this will be very good practice. These days when we play Abhek Babdada's drill of five forms, says within 1 second, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The chakra has to move, no? Not one by one, all five. So it really becomes Swadarshan Chakradhari, in the sense not only we adopt chakra, but it can also destroy all whatever is devil and negative, evil. So it's a very beautiful practice, and as we all, whenever we sit together, we are determined to practice, experience, experiment, and become. Right? So that's what we all have to do. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti. Welcome to Avikti Cruise. Today we are going to two places in the Caribbean. The two places are Haiti and St. Kitts. Oh, let's go to the